he discovered that phytoplasmas change plants into the living dead. They basically, what they do is they change the flowers of the plant into leaf-like structures, and therefore the plant cannot reproduce anymore. It doesn't form any offspring or any seed, and therefore the plant stays alive just for the pathogen. It's under the spell of the pathogen. Phytoplasma is transmitted by leafhoppers, and these introduce the phytoplasma inside the phloem tissues, in the vascular tissues of the plant. And when the phytoplasmas are in the vascular tissue, they spread throughout the plant systemically from the roots to the flowers. But the first thing you see is that the flowers produce fluorescence, which means that the petals are slowly becoming greener and greener and greener. And then at the end, they will also produce other leaf-like tissues, for example, stems growing out of the flowers, starting again production of new leaf-like flowers. The symptomatic plants are very attractive to the leafhopper factors. These leafhopper factors, they feed from the plant or reproduce on the plant, and while they're doing this, they acquire the phytoplasma, and when they become infected, they may move to other plants and then transmit the phytoplasma. Phytoplasmas infect a very broad host range, including pear, apple, oilseed rape and tomato, and they interfere with these plant developmental processes and also at the same time with plant immunity. And by understanding how they do this, we can understand more how plant developmental processes and plant resistance are integrated. And this will then inform us how to make crops better, including how they produce more yields and how to use less pesticides.